What lessons can we learn from the gospel of today? What does Mary Magdalene mean when she says, "If you have carried him away, tell me where and I will take him away"? What mission does Jesus entrust to Mary Magdalene? All these questions and more answered during today's episode of Daily Reflections. The determination of Mary Magdalene. The death of her great friend prompts Mary to lose her sense of life. But she does not give up her search. She goes to the tomb in order to meet again the one whom death has taken away. There are moments in a life in which everything crumbles. It seems that everything is finished. Disasters, betrayals may cause us to feel lost, but God always gives us hope and makes us discover that love is stronger than death and defeat. The Lord allows desolation, but He also provides the consolation that we need. Chapter 20 in John's Gospel also speaks about diverse episodes which indicates the richness of the experience of resurrection. In the way of describing the apparition of Jesus to Mary Magdalene, one is aware of the different stages of the road that she had to follow, of the sorrowful search until the time of encounter at Easter. There are also stages through which we all have to pass throughout our life in seeking God and living the gospel. Which brings us to the next point. Mary weeps, but she also seeks. There was a very strong love connection between Jesus and Mary Magdalene. She was one of the few persons who had the courage to remain with Jesus up to the moment of his death on the cross. When she goes to the tomb, she finds it empty, but she doesn't give up. She is eager to find Jesus. We too can take inspiration from Mary Magdalene, the eagerness to find Jesus in every situation of our lives. Mary teaches us that if we seek, we will be given the grace to seek what we are looking for. Which brings us to the third point, the mission of Mary Magdalene. Mary Magdalene recognizes Jesus when he calls her by name. Earlier, she mistakes him to be a gardener, but once Jesus calls her by name, she knows that it is the Lord. Sometimes our preoccupations don't allow us to see that the Lord is with us, journeying in our lives at all times. Jesus too calls us by name. There are so many instances in our lives that we could identify where God calls us by name. But what is my response to His call? Mary Magdalene receives the mission to announce the resurrection to the apostles. In fact, it is the same Jesus, but the way of being together with her is not the same as it was before. As Jesus tells her, "Do not cling to me, as I have not yet ascended to my Father." Mary has to let Jesus go and assume her mission to announce to the brothers that Jesus has ascended to the Father. Today we celebrate the feast of Mary Magdalene, whom Pope Francis calls as the Apostle of the Apostles. Today, we can thank God for all the wonders that He has done in our lives. Here are certain points for our personal reflection. Have you ever had an experience which gave you the feeling of loss and death? What was it like? What gave you new life and gave you back the hope and joy of living? Second, do we look for Jesus in the past as a historical figure, when He is present right before us in the poor and the outcast we meet every day? And third, what can we do to be more aware of Jesus in those that we meet today? These points can be of great help to reflect on today's gospel. And if you like our reflection, do share the good news of our Lord. Have a good day, and may God bless you all. Amen.